Hello everyone, in this video we will talk about the laboratory diagnosis of the Pseudomonas. Pseudomonas is gram-negative bacilli and have pili and flagella on their surface. So gram-negative, it means pink in color, and here the pili and flagellae. They are non-sugar fermenter. They will not ferment sucrose, glucose or lactose. They are oxidase positive and catalase positive, so they will produce respective enzymes. They are capsulated, and capsule is one of the virulence factor of them. They are obligate aerobe. It means they need oxygen to grow. They are non-fastidious, and Pseudomonas is present abundant in our environment. Pseudomonas infection is a more common in the hospitalized patient. We can suffer from the bacteremia, ventilator-associated pneumonia, chronic respiratory tract infections, ear infections, eye infections, skin and soft tissue infections, green nail syndrome, and many more. I like to add that Pseudomonas aeruginosa produce probably the largest number of the toxins and enzymes, largest number among all the gram-negative bacteria. Let's start our topic, laboratory diagnosis of the Pseudomonas. The first method is specimen collection. Second method is direct smear microscopy. Third, culture. Fourth, culture smear and motility. Fifth, biochemical identification. And sixth, antimicrobial susceptibility test. And the last, typing of the Pseudomonas. We will describe each of them in this video. Let's start with the first, specimen collection. As we know, Pseudomonas can cause various type of infections. So depending upon the site of infection, we will take the specimen, example pus, blood, urine, wound swab, CSF, etc., and we'll see them. Second method is direct smear microscopy. As we know, we will see the plenty of pus cells and the gram-negative capsulated pseudomonas and no spores. Third method is culture. We will incubate Pseudomonas aerobically at 37 degrees Celsius for 24 hours. In following culture, first culture is Pepton water, second is nutrient agar, third blood agar, fourth McConkie agar, and fifth selective media cetrimide agar. Pseudomonas form uniform turbidity with the surface pellicle in Pepton water. In nutrient agar, it produces the large opaque irregular colony with the metallic sheen. Some strains make pigments like pyosin and pyoverdin. Strain containing pyosin pigment will give blue green colony, and strains containing pyoverdin will give yellow green colony. This colony have the sweet ether or alcohol fruity odor. Now in blood agar, it will show beta-hemolytic gray moist colonies. So imagine that this is the blood agar, and we will incubate the Pseudomonas at 37 degrees Celsius for 24 hours aerobically, and we will find the grayish moist colony on blood agar showing beta-hemolysis. So colony will show beta-hemolysis and their grayish moist. On McConkie agar, they will give non-lactose fermenter colony. It means the pale colony. We know that Pseudomonas is non-lactose fermenter, and cetrimide agar is the selective media. It is useful for isolation of the Pseudomonas from the mixed growth of purulent specimens. The fourth method is the culture smear microscopy. In culture smear microscopy, we will see the gram-negative pink-colored bacilli and actively motile bacilli. Fifth is biochemical test for the identification. Pseudomonas give these tests. First test is oxidase test, second catalase test, third oxidative fermentative test of Hodge and Leifson, and the ICUT test. We know that Pseudomonas is oxidase positive and catalase positive. In Hodge and Leifson's oxidative fermentative test, it will show oxidative pattern, and Pseudomonas is indole negative, citrate positive, urease negative. So Pseudomonas is negative, positive and negative. Triple sugar ion test will give us alkaline slant and alkaline butt with no gas and no H2S. Now the sixth method is the antimicrobial susceptibility test. For better treatment for antibiotics, we check the resistance of bacteria on Müller-Hinton agar by the disc diffusion method. Now the last laboratory diagnosis by the typing of Pseudomonas. Typing of Pseudomonas include four typing. First is bacteriocin typing, second is antibiogram typing, third is sero grouping, and fourth is the molecular methods. Bacteriocin typing is also known as pyocin typing, and it is based on the bacteriocin producing ability that inhibits certain indicator of bacterial strains. Antibiogram typing is easy and commonly used, and it is based on the antimicrobial resistant patterns. Serotyping is based on the O and H antigen, and we have been recognized 17 serotypes of the Pseudomonas aeruginosis with the help of this. And molecular method include PFGE, pulse field gel electrophoresis, and the sequence based typing method. Now the last and important treatment of the Pseudomonas infection. As we know, Pseudomonas is inherently resistant to the antibiotics, but the drug of choice currently are the amoxicillin and IV of ceftriaxone.